It's like business is completely unlimited. And so what you have to do is just get a system in place that keeps you at the top of what you can handle at all times.
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
Right. I think he hit the nail on the head. You don't know too much about our business, but I feel like a lot of us are shuffling to keep organized with the leads that come in the database. There's some of that
right.
For a year even. Why are we trying to follow up with them just to say hello? Because we don't want to lose them potentially, you know?
It's okay. What you have to do is you have to get in this mindset that it's okay to lose people. You see, you have to sacrifice. You're not going to, there's no system out there, my guy, that will win every single lead.
Right.
You know, there's thousands and thousands and hundreds of thousands and millions of real estate agents. So, you know, you're just not gonna win every single prospect. So what you have to do is put a system in place that's gonna give you the best opportunity to capture as many as you can. The ones that fall through, you know, you can't win them all. And so you can't sit here and worry about, am I gonna capture every single lead? You just do the best you can do. It's kind of like not worried about the results kind of thing. You just go out there and do your best. The weekly email is a safety net on the back of my business, right? Whereas if I show property to people and they don't buy anything, right? They say they even quit returning my calls and went totally ghost on me after I spent 3 days showing them property. That's fine. They're still going to get that email. And in 3 years, they call me back and say, hey, remember me? I'm going to say, yeah. I'm going to remember. Oh, yeah, they're the ones that went ghost on me. I showed property 2-3 days. But I'm not going to bring that up. I'm just going to say, yeah, what can I do for you? Oh, we like this house. Okay, cool. Let's go. Boom, we write an offer. And so that email is a safety net on the back of my business, whereas it's not going to catch every single lead. Some are still going to fall through the holes of the net, but it's a pretty secure net. Like it's gonna do its job for the most part. And so you just have to be happy with, you know, and satisfied with, you know, you have to have a system in place you feel confident will capture the most back end. You know, like this is where you win. It's not necessarily in the front end. Everybody does a good job on the front end, getting the leads, following up, showing the property, writing the offers. Everybody does good there. But what's going on the backside? What kind of safety net do you have on the backside of your business that will give you at least a chance? See, a lot of people will take that lead, that buyer lead that didn't call back or didn't answer the calls, and they'll just kind of throw them away, or they don't have really anything on the back end of their business to give them a chance. See, I just want an opportunity. You know, I just want, if I can even get like a 10% chance on the back of my business to get some of these people to come back to me later, you know, then, and I don't know what the percentage is. You know, I may get 20%, 50%, 70%, 5%, I don't know what it is. It's enough to keep me busy, keep me selling 100 properties a year, you know what I mean? That's the main part is, it's like business is completely unlimited. And so what you have to do is just get a system in place that keeps you at the top of what you can handle at all times. See what I'm saying? Like your business and your success is predicated on how much you can handle at once, you know, as a team, mentally, whatever. And so you got to figure out where that limit is, okay? How many active listings can we handle at once? You know, and how many active listings and pending deals can we handle at one time, right? What is the maximum? That's what you have to figure out as a team or whatever you guys are. You have to figure out what your maximum limit is and what you can handle. How many active listings and how many pending deals? Because there is a limit. You know, you can sit here and tell me you can handle 300 active listings, but I don't believe you, right? And you know, you can sit here and tell me you can handle 50 pending deals, but I don't believe you, you know? You have to figure out where that limit is, and you may know that limit, right? You may not know that limit. If you don't know that limit, then it's time to overwhelm ourselves with business to get to that limit so that we know what that is. Then we know what our full potential is as far as what we can handle. And now we want to have a system in place that enables us to stay right there at what we can handle at all times. See what I'm saying? Then you're going to get to where you're reaching your real full potential. See what I'm saying? So me, I like to have 50 listings and 20 pendings. You know, 10 to 20 pendings and 50 listings is kind of where it's my happy place. It's kind of where I like to live, you know. That keeps me at 100 deals a year, a million a year. That's kind of where I want to stay while I'm building this coaching business. So I'm doing two things at once, spending half my time on one, half my time on the other. You know, if I were just doing real estate, then maybe that would be a little higher, but I'm really comfortable there. So I know where I want to be, and I have the systems in place to keep me right there. I know that if I get down a little bit, I can just turn right around and get on the phone and ramp it up and get it right. You know, I know how to work the system to stay right there.